First, the pay to stay. Chris Starwell from the Washington Examiner crunching all the numbers. So, Chris, they're looking at a big pot here in numbers and some substantial money we're spending there, aren't they?
Yeah, obviously the first Obama doctrine, if you'll call it, the war of necessity, the plan that the president laid out in March and then doubled down on this summer, where you build an Afghan army and police force of several hundred thousand, maybe 400,000 people, where you increase the American troop presence, and we're hearing obviously numbers like 40,000. This is a hugely expensive undertaking. This is tens and hundreds maybe of billions of dollars over time. The Iraq surge cost us an extra $5 or $6 billion a year. This could be double that.
All right, so we've already known the 8 years we've been in Afghanistan has been about $229 billion. And we know that just the added troop commitment, if we do the 40,000 troop commitment, that would be another $3 billion a year in Afghanistan.
At least, yeah.
So they're looking at the dollar worth of all of this, right?
Well, sure. I mean, look, if you're Vice President Biden and you're making your pitch for why we should have a smaller footprint in Afghanistan, why we should sort of leave the Karzai government maybe to its own devices and focus on fighting terrorism wherever it is and not have a nation-specific mission in Afghanistan, one of the pitches that you can make to the president is, look, boss, we can cut the costs here from $3 or $7 billion a year down to $1 billion a year, and we can also cut off the possibility of tens and tens of billions of dollars in nation building down the road. The president is in a real cash crunch right now. He is tremendously short on resources. He's not able to borrow more money to finance his plans. We're waiting for the CBO to score this health care bill. I think we're going to be back in the $1 trillion range.
But you know, Chris, the sad truth of it is that if it's a $1 trillion health care range cost, and I think you're right about that, then, and I hate to say it, I'm the last to say it, but this almost seems like chump change, what we're spending there. And I know we need to get money from a variety of sources to address these costs, but it must say something about our times where, you know, a few billion in Afghanistan doesn't, you know, add up to a prescription plan, you know?
Well, and if you think about it in these terms, we fund the military annually less than $600 billion. The president's talking about cutting that from Medicare.
Right.
When you start to think about the scope of the cost of social welfare programs in the United States versus military costs and commitments are a pittance compared to what we have to do for Medicare and Medicaid as it exists. When you talk about adding another $1 trillion to the program, or if you talk about a second stimulus to try and peel back some of this mounting unemployment, if you talk about extending the TARP, you're talking, as they would say here, you know, in real money. You're talking about trillions of dollars. We're already looking at adding $9 trillion to the deficit. So the cost in Afghanistan is significant, but the fact that anybody's even looking at it indicates how cash crunched this administration is in terms of paying for its agenda.
All right. Always good stuff, Chris. Thank you. Good seeing you again.